What you are looking at are the remnants of a natural disaster which once wreaked absolute devastation across the region, with this pristine landscape a decade after the disaster struck instead looking like this. In fact, if you had somehow managed to walk 50 miles to the north, west, south, or even east, you would have seen the exact same thing. No life, no trees, maybe a blade of grass or two if you were lucky, but most importantly, the largest field of degassing fumaroles on the planet, comprising tens of thousands of degassing vents which made much of the valley completely toxic to most forms of life. Fast forwarding to the present, while the area has clearly recovered and today it merely looks like a peaceful valley with a large open plain, there is a specific reason why there are no large mountains here. You see, there used to be a similar series of rugged mountains here. Then, 764,800 years ago, one of the largest volcanic eruptions to ever occur in the United States happened, causing a 20-mile-long stretch of land to subside by nearly 10,000 feet or 3 kilometers. This subsidence was caused by rock collapsing downwards to fill the empty space in what had previously been a very large and full magma chamber in a complex which is today known as the Long Valley Caldera. So, why is there not still a giant hole in the ground, or at the very least, a supermassive caldera lake such as seen at many other large calderas? The answer is that while yes, the ground did subside by up to 3,000 meters or 9,842 feet, the eruption deposits this 60-long ultraplane eruption generated covered this caldera by up to 1,500 meters or 4,921 feet thick of volcanic rock. And then, in the time since, up to 622 meters or 2,041 feet thick of viscous towering rhyolite lava flows were added, while at the same time, the center of this caldera has been uplifted by 400 meters or 1,212 feet. While the Long Valley Caldera has not erupted in 16,000 years, it is still considered as an active, or at the very minimum, a potentially active volcano. The reason for this relates to how it behaves differently than most volcanoes, due in part to its magma chamber which holds 1,000 cubic kilometers of magma. Not only does all of this magma create dozens of fumaroles, hot springs, and even occasional geysers, but the Long Valley Caldera was also the site of two failed magmatic intrusions in 1980 and 1982. Because of this, it is deemed that there is a low but still technically possible chance that this volcano could generate a small to medium-sized explosive eruption in the next millennia. Such an eruption could create a cinder cone and a mildly explosive eruption, or a rhyolite lava flow and a highly explosive Merapi-type volcanian eruption, which could even generate regional pyroclastic flows and ashfall. As a result of these hazards, with the next eruption most likely to occur near the western caldera rim of the complex, the U.S. Geological Survey designated the Long Valley Caldera as a very high-threat volcano. Eruptions of the Long Valley Caldera can be traced all the way back to 3.6 million years ago, when a lava dome-forming eruption emplaced a trachydesite lava flow high on a peak northeast of Laurel Mountain. Scattered regional eruptions continued for the next 500,000 years, emplacing mostly mafic vents. Eruptions then moved into the area inside the modern caldera 3.1 million years ago, although a dominant eruptive center did not emerge until 2.2 million years ago. Almost all following pre-caldera eruptions between 2.2 and 0.76 million years ago constructed a vast obsidian-rich lava dome complex known as Glass Mountain. At least 59 distinct eruptions occurred here, emplacing 100 cubic kilometers of high silica rhyolite lava. After the caldera formed in a major VEI-7 eruption, a widespread series of rhyolite lava flows covered the caldera's center, involving dozens of highly explosive eruptions across a time span of 750,000 to 640,000 years ago in primarily VEI-4 to VEI-5 events. As the underlying magma chamber was partially refilled, the center of its edifice was uplifted by more than 1,000 feet. Additional eruptions constructed more large rhyolite lava flows such as the North Dome 525,000 years ago, Hot Creek 288,000 years ago, West Coulee 150,000 years ago, and Deer Mountain 115,000 years ago. the famous Devil's Postpile lava flow with its scenic and tall basaltic trachyandesite columns with polygon shapes formed 82,000 years ago. All eruptions since then have been far more mafic and solely occurred in the western end of the caldera, specifically constructing cinder cones and basalt to basaltic trachyandesite eruptions 66,000 years ago, 31,000 years ago, and most recently 16,000 years ago. The last eruption constructed three cinder cone vents, two spatter cone vents, several small lava flows, and a phreatic explosion crater. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Lori Martinelli, for supporting this channel.